My prayer altar, receive divine fire and connection in the name of Jesus. My prayer altar, receive divine fire and connection. Open your mouth and pray wherever you are. My prayer altar, receive divine fire and connection in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen. Building an altar. Building an altar. Children of God, we want to learn how to build an altar. And we will learn it from Abraham. Abraham has a message for us. He is going to teach us about faith to rebuild and to take back. In answer to the call and the promises of God, God told Abraham to come out from his father's house to the land of promise that he will show him. And God said, I will bless you and make you a blessing. And Abraham does something particular and extremely significant. He built an altar to the Lord. Let's open our Bible to look at Genesis chapter 12. We shall read from verse 7 to 8. Book of Genesis chapter 12, from verse 7 to 8. And the Lord appeared unto Abraham and said unto the seed, will I give this land? And there builded he an altar unto the Lord who appeared unto him. And he removed from thence unto a mountain on the east of Bethel, and pitched his tent, having Bethel on the west, and Ai on the east. And there he builded an altar unto the Lord, and called upon the name of the Lord. Brethren, where is your own altar? When do you have time to communicate with God? When do you have time to cry loud to God, to worship the Lord? When you look at the idol worshiper, anytime they wake up, the first thing that they do, they go to their idols, they worship their idols, they appease the gods. But we that we call ourselves Christian, we don't have time. There is no prayer altar. We don't have time to fellowship, to worship our God. Brethren, the altar that Abraham built, the altar was a testimony, a public commitment, a vow. It was as if Abraham had said, this is the expression of my faith. I want every person who sees this altar to know that I am not ashamed to proclaim that I belong to God. I believe in Him. My faith is in His presence. Are you not ashamed of God? Anytime they ask you to go out and preach the gospel, you are ashamed. You find it so difficult to preach the word of God. Children of God, this concept of an altar to the Lord was extremely intense, serious and binding in Abrahamic and Jewish culture of Abraham's day. In fact, building an altar means to be truthful, honest, and serious with God, to be sincere, and to make decisions with all one heart before God with truth and commitment. I know fully well that many that are listening under the sound of my voice walk with this kind of heart towards God. It is not to boast or for show. You really want to please God, to obey Him, and to be true to God's wills and His words. You are genuine. Your consecration is authentic. You have built an altar of faith, prayer, worship, generosity, forgiveness, and sanctification before your God. You are alive with the faith. Because the Bible makes us to understand in the book of Philippians chapter 1 verse 6. Book of Philippians chapter 1 verse 6. Being confident of this very thing, that he which had begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. Brethren, beyond the accolade, career success, or promotion you may accomplish on this earth, you live each of the day to hear the word of God, his voice of welcoming you into the portal of the afterlife with this word, according to the book of Matthew chapter 25 verse 21, which says, "Well done, my good and faithful servant, enter into the joy of your master." So shall it be for you and I in the name of Jesus. You have built an altar before God. If you have not built an altar, do it now. You need to build an altar where you call on God wherever you are. Peradventure you are listening under the sound of my voice and you have not given your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. This is a great opportunity for you to accept Jesus as your Lord and your personal Savior. Tomorrow might be too late. Before we continue our prayer, if you have made up your mind that you want to surrender your life to the Lord Jesus, I want you to lay your right hand on your chest and you will say laughter and say, "Father, I come before you. Lord Jesus, come into my life. Take control of my life. As from today, I say bye-bye to the devil. I enter into the kingdom of light. In the name of Jesus. Amen." I congratulate us. We have made a right choice for our life. Let us open our mouth and begin to confess now. Say, "Father, forgive me. Every known and unknown sin in my life. Father, forgive me, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, forgive me, O Lord. Have mercy, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, have mercy, O Lord. In Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen." Father, in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we thank you because you are the Lord. Father, we thank you for the life of those that accepted Jesus into their life today. Father, accept them, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, forgive every known and unknown sin. Have mercy upon their life in the name of Jesus. By your mercy, O Lord, baptize them with your Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. And let your name alone be glorified. For in Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen. Are you ready to pray? I want us to open our mouth and appreciate the love of God. The God that count you and I worthy to see the light of today. Magnify the name of the Lord for the gift of life. Glorify his holy name. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Father, we say thank you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. We give you adoration. Blessed be your holy name. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' wonderful name, we give thanks. Amen. You will shout loud and clear. Say, "My Father, turn my prayer altar to solution grant to all issues of life. In the name of Jesus." Open your mouth and pray now. "My Father, turn my prayer altar to solution grant to all issues of life. In the name of Jesus." "My Father, turn my prayer altar to solution grant to all issues of life. In the name of Jesus." "My Father, turn my prayer altar to solution grant to all issues of life. In the mighty name of Jesus." "My Father, turn my prayer altar to solution grant to all issues of life. In the name of Jesus." In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. I like that. Say, "Boasting power against my life, die in the name of Lord Jesus, boasting powers against my life. Da, 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 in the name of Jesus. Da, da, in the name of Jesus, boasting powers against my life. Die, in the name of Jesus, boasting powers against the power of God in my life. Da, 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 in the name of Jesus, boasting powers against the power of God in my life. Die, 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 die. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Say powers mocking my prayers. Holy Ghost fire burn them to ashes. In the name of Jesus, power mocking my prayers. Holy Ghost fire burn them to ashes. In the name of Jesus, powers mocking my prayer life. Holy Ghost fire burn them to ashes. Holy Ghost fire burn them to ashes. Holy Ghost fire burn them to ashes. Power mocking my prayer life. Holy Ghost fire burn them to ashes in the name of Jesus. For in Jesus mighty name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Father, we thank you because you are the Lord. Glory be to your holy name. Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we thank you because you are God. We return the glory, honor, adoration unto thee for this wonderful morning. Glory be to your holy name in Jesus' name. Father, accept our thanksgiving in Jesus' name. Heavenly Father, we come to your presence, O Lord. Father, forgive, O Lord, every known and unknown sin in our life in the name of Jesus. You are merciful God. Have mercy upon our life in the name of Jesus. Father, have mercy, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Your children has cried loud unto thee. Father, in the name of Jesus, let there be visitation in their life. In the name of Jesus, the Spirit to worship you, to serve you, in the name of Jesus, release it upon your children, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. I pray for you wherever you are. Your prayer altar shall receive fresh fire of Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus. I pray for you, and that prayer altar shall receive fresh fire of God, the God of Elijah, shall arise and sanctify your prayer altar in the name of Jesus. Anytime you call on God, the God that answered by fire shall over answer you by fire. Heaven shall recognize your voice for divine response in the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son, in the name of God the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Blessed be your holy name. Thank you for your word. Glory be to your holy name. For in Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen. Let's share the grace and fellowship. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God bless you all. Have a blessed day in the name of Jesus. Amen.